Angular continues to evolve. What kind of tools, what kind of setups should you use in 2025? Now, based on a question on Reddit, I decided to come up with a video where I present the Angular setup that I would use if I would start a new project right now. Signals represent one of the most significant shifts in Angular. Although we don't have signal forms, we don't have an HTTP resource, so a lot of parts of our code stay not signalized, and the effect function at the time of this recording is still in developer preview, my recommendation here is very clear: go all in with signals. Why shouldn't we wait for signals to be complete? The answer lies in the cost of the rewrites. If we don't start with signals now, then we have to use RxJS for reactivity. Now the problem is that a switch, a transition from RxJS to signals is quite expensive. You have to realize that RxJS comes with a different mental model, it has a different paradigm, and also different patterns. On the other hand, if you use signals right now, you ensure that your code base is already future-proof. Not all areas of your code will be signalized. I mentioned forms and HTTP client before, but that's not the problem. You just step out of the signals and just do it the traditional way. For example, if you want to set the value to the form group, you just use an effect. The key point is, if you use signals right now, you only have a partial rewrite of the non-signalized areas. If you skip signals at all, you will face a full rewrite. For new application, I would even go further and I would use resource or Rx resource, although they are still experimental. Why? Because usually writing a new Angular application takes more than just 2 or 3 months. So at the time that you are ready for going live, those functions will already be stable or at least in developer preview. I prefer the Angular CLI because it provides me with everything that I need to get started, and I don't want to have an additional layer of complexity in the very beginning. Nginx provides a set of pre-configured tools, yes, but I also found out that installing them manually these days works quite seamlessly with existing schematics or the simple setup functions that we have. As I said, Nginx is for me an additional layer of complexity which is too much in the early phases. It comes with its own learning curve, migrations, and usually you have to put in a little bit more effort in these things compared to the Angular CLI. But if you find later that now it's time to use Nginx, it's very easy. You just need to run Nginx import. That said, Nginx offers real value if your application grows, be it the building tools or the management for mono repositories. When it comes to the UI, I usually use Angular Material combined with Tailwind. Angular Material provides a robust set of components and it's part of the Angular project. The Angular project consists of the Angular framework, the Angular CLI and Material. And that means it's officially supported, maintained and kept in sync. For me, Tailwind is the perfect complement to Angular Material. I use it more for the fine-grained customizations like adding margins, positioning elements, or adding some utility classes. I rarely encounter unique UI needs or have an existing design system. I usually work with applications that I like to call UI boring enterprise applications. So Angular Material and Tailwind is just fine. To be fair, choosing the right testing framework at the moment is not easy. Since I go with the Angular CLI, I stick to the officially supported ones, which is the pair Jasmine and Karma. You might have heard that these two have reached their end of life. That's not true. Karma is the only one that has reached its end of life, and it will be replaced by the modern web test runner. But we don't have to care about it. Why? Because all the testing code that we write uses Jasmine, and Jasmine is not going to be replaced, it just stays. What about Jest and Retest? There are official plans to support Jest. I personally hope that it might become Retest, which is the more modern version, but I'm afraid the Angular team has already made their decision for Jest. For end-to-end testing, it's going to be Playwright. If I don't have an existing code, then I don't see any reason why I shouldn't use it. Playwright is fast, is modern, and reliable. Unfortunately, there is no component testing for Angular in Playwright, but I can tell you there is some work going on in the background, and maybe there will come a solution which is community driven. Sticking to code guidelines is essential for keeping the code base clean and maintainable. ESLint is the standard, ESLint via Angular ESLint in that case. Angular ESLint also incorporates the Angular style guide, and in addition, I also install the ESLint plugin unused imports, which, as the name says, removes imports which I don't use anymore. While there is a linting plugin for Prettier as well, I don't use that one because I don't want that formatting violations end up or show up as linting errors. Then everything is red. What I do instead is that I try that my Git hooks are running Prettier. For that, I use lint staged, which only applies Prettier to the staged files. And to ensure the Git hooks are set up and are running, I use Husky. When it comes to enforcing architectural rules, so I have modules and I want to have module boundaries and dependency rules between them, then I'm going to use Sheriff, which also has an integration into ESLint. Angular signals are made to contain state, and that's why if I want to use a state management library, I want to use one which is built on top of the signals, and for me, that's the NgRx SignalStore. I use the SignalStore for local but also for global state management. When do I decide to bring it in? Well, whenever I find myself writing a service that holds a larger signal with some logic around it. The SignalStore, by the way, is not boilerplatey and it provides a clear standardization. As for the NgRx global store for a new application, I only see it if I have the need for an event-based system. To be honest, I almost never encounter them, and even if, then I would wait for the events extension that is planned for the NgRx signal store. A heavily debated topic is Inject versus constructor-based dependency injection. If I write Java Spring applications, I use the constructor. In Angular, I use the Inject function. Inject also works within functions, which means my HTTP interceptors and my router guards depend on it. And who knows, maybe in the future there will be an alternative authoring format which uses functions instead of classes. There are also other reasons to use the Inject function. For example, it provides type-safe injection tokens, and it also eliminates the need for property decorators which are not standardized. But for me personally, the key argument is the use in functions. Server-side rendering, hydration, and incremental hydration are essential for any internet-facing application with demands for initial loading performance and good CEO. Before I joined Angular Architects, I was working on an application where these features would have been a game changer. Just having access to incremental hydration, that would have been paradise for us. That said, these capabilities come at a cost. They will increase the complexity for your development and your deployment processes. Because of that, I would only recommend to use server-side rendering if you have the need for it. But then an absolute yes. When it comes to package managers, I use PNPM over NPM and Yarn. Yarn is also fine, but PNPM, we see the trend goes towards it. It's fast, it's stable, and also reliable. Artificial intelligence, absolutely. It has become a necessity. I use Copilot and ChatGPT, and as an IDE, I use IntelliJ because of my Java background, and I still use the Light theme. For this year, I want to try out Bun as an alternative to Node.js. I also want to try out the Angular 10-stack query, which is gaining some traction for managing synchronizing state with the server, of course also in combination with the SignalStore, and Analog, the meta framework for Angular. I need it to create my NgNews website, which I've planned for quite some time now. I also want to try out Cursor, that's this AI IDE, have heard some good things about it. And for Angular, I'm very looking forward to the HTTP resource, hopefully with an integration of existing HTTP interceptors, and obviously the signal forms. And that's it. If you have another setup or use some tools that I'm not aware of, then please let me know. I'm also providing these tools configured with the latest version of Angular with a GitHub repository. If you have any feedback, comments, as always, then please let me know. And I would be happy if you subscribe to my channel and give this video a like. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.